And those are valuable, valuable jobs out
yes,
there on the beaches.
Are.
You've seen how crowded
necessary,
they get.
Necessary. Yep. Very necessary.
Absolutely.
It's a good idea to have those people out there. Well, we had some rain today. We had a little bit of rain. Not as much. It wasn't as widespread as we had hoped. It was more in fits and starts that we saw the rain showers. It was all pretty well clumped together. East of I-75, you can see where the heaviest rainfalls took place. And we saw anywhere from 2 to 3 inches of rainfall east of I-75 falling. And then you can see the fallout from everywhere else. And we saw less than an inch of rainfall, less than a tenth of an inch of rainfall in most locations west of I-75. So here's where the majority of the rain was taking place, was east of I-75, and then all of the movement went on towards the east. And we do have a cold front to our north, and that frontal system is pretty much situated right here across north central Florida, and it's going to be moving through the state by tomorrow. And as it does so, it's going to start to draw in this drier air that's now across the panhandle and will soon be here across central Florida. But in advance of that front, we are still looking at some cloud cover, and we're going to get partly cloudy skies. Then we'll see a little bit more cloud cover coming on through, but all the rain is over with. It's all over the east coast of Florida, and we're not looking at any other showers to develop here, not throughout the overnight time period, and not even into the morning hours tomorrow. So tonight, we've got just some clouds that will be coming on in, and that's going to be about the end of it. And we may get a little bit thicker cloud cover during the time period of about 1 to 2 in the morning, and then things are going to be back to plenty of clear skies for us during the morning hours tomorrow and into the rest of the day. So that's how things are shaping up. We've got the winds starting to come in out of the north-northwest right now, and here's where that frontal system is, and you can see it coming on through the state, and it's going to take most of the day on Monday to get all the way through the state of Florida, but we're going to be left with beautiful sky conditions, and we are not expecting rain in the forecast for several days. All the way through Thursday, we're going to be looking at fair skies. You can see we're not expecting any rain at all during the overnight time period. Negligible rain chances for tomorrow, and we're going to be seeing, for the most part, mostly sunny skies, and we may get a couple of clouds coming on through, but that's going to be about it. You can see that the winds are coming in out of the northwest, and they're fairly calm. 2 to 4 miles per hour, and this is true down the coastline, and the dew points are starting to come down as well, especially across the panhandle where we're already seeing some of that drier air coming on through, and the lower the dew point, the more comfortable it's going to be. So readings in the 60s and 70s don't translate into great comfort, but we are going to start to see those levels coming down tomorrow once that cold front passes through. So temperatures at this hour in the 70s still. It's still kind of muggy out there. We've got winds for boaters tomorrow out of the north-northwest at 10 to 15 knots, seas 1 to 2 feet with a moderate chop, and the temperature at the beach will be about 86 degrees. Over the next several days, we're going to keep those temperatures in the mid to upper 80s, and this will be true all the way through Thursday. In fact, all week pretty much, we're going to see these warmer temperatures, and there will be days where we could get up to a high of 90. That is not out of the question. So don't let these temperatures fool you so much. We could see some 90s. And then we get a plume of moisture coming in just in time for next weekend. We'll start the rains all over again. Adam?